This is Mike from MinIO. In today's video, we'll be installing and running MinIO on Docker using the Docker CLI. What will we cover today? We're going to run MinIO from the Docker CLI. We're going to access the MinIO server via the browser. We're also going to install the MinIO client and attach to a local server running MinIO that's running on top of Docker. If you're looking for some documentation, you can follow this link to install Docker on your system, as well as visit the MinIO docs page to understand how to run MinIO as a container. Note that this can be run on Podman or Docker. In today's video, we're going to be running it on top of Docker. So here we are on our server. You'll note that we are running Docker 20.10.18. It's recommended that you run the latest version of Docker as you can, so you can have all the stability and capabilities of that current version of Docker. The first thing we're going to do today is make a directory that lets us store our MinIO data. Next, we'll run this Docker command, and I'll walk through it with you real quick. We'll do Docker run. We'll map the port from the localhost to the container port of 9000, as well as 9090 to the container port of 9090. We'll name it MinIO. We'll point to that directory we just created at minio/data, and we'll mount that inside the container as data. And we will run the root and user and password as MinIO admin. Lastly, we'll direct the console address to 9090. You can see that this is now running in the foreground, and we'll go ahead and access that web console. Here we are at the web console, and we'll go ahead and log in using the username and password we defined in the Docker run command. And now that we're logged in, let's go ahead and create a bucket and upload something to that bucket just to make sure that things are working as expected. All right, so our file upload is complete. Now let's jump back over to the terminal and see if we can see these files. Here we are back at the console. Note that because we did not use the -D option, which is detached, this is running in the foreground. We'll need to press Control C to exit out of this. And now we can use the tree command to see the file we just uploaded. As you can see, we see the directory or the bucket that we created, MinIO Docker test, as well as the zip file that we uploaded. Lastly, let's take a look at how to run Docker in the background so that you can still interact with the terminal when the container is up and running. Note that I've used the same command as before, but I've added this -itd. This means interactive, terminal, and detached. Lastly, if we want to stop this container, we can run docker rm -f, which is force, and the container name that we gave it, MinIO. This will stop the Docker process, and MinIO is no longer running on our system. Hopefully with this video and the documentation provided, you can quickly get MinIO up and running on Docker on whichever system you choose. If you'd like more information about MinIO, please visit us at min.io, or if you'd like to join the discussion, please join us at minio.slack.com. Thanks and have a good one.